Hello friends, this is Shravan. This is my YouTube channel Civil Engineering by Shravan. To subscribe my channel, click on subscribe button and click on bell icon for more interesting updates. In this video lecture, I will explain you analysis and designing of elevated steel tank by using StatPro VITI software. So initially I will show you the model for the respective elevated tank. Go to StatPro software here. So this is my model for the respective elevator tank. I will model this respective tank in StatPro software and I will apply the load cases like dead load and hydrostatic pressure, and I will design this respective tank by using IS 800 code. So for that, initially go to StatPro software, click on StatPro software, click on new project. Here we need to select the spacing option. Just we need to give the file name. Just I am taking the file name is tank. Save your file location. Just I am taking my file location to the desktop, steel tank, click on OK. So here we need to select the length units will be in meter as well as force units will be in kilonewton as per Indian standard system. Click on next button, click on finish button. So after that, the software will be opened like this. So initially we need to keep the structure in front of you. So for this respective elevated tank, initially we need to model the beams and column sections. So initially I will model the bottom floor for this respective tank. So for that, initially go to geometry option here. Click on run structure wizard option. So here we need to select the model type. This time selecting the model type is frame models. So in this frame models, we need to select the bay frames initially. So after that, we need to give the dimensions for the length, height as well as width, and the number of bays along length direction, width direction and height direction. So here I am assuming length will be consisting of 6 meter. Again, I am taking height is 3 meter. Again, I am taking width is also 6 meter. So here we need to enter the number of bays along length direction initially. So here I am assuming number of bays along length direction will be 2, and number of bays along height direction will be 1, and number of bays along width direction will be 2. Click on apply. So this is my ground model. So we need to import this respective model from structure wizard option to StatPro software. So for that, initially click on cancel button, click on yes button, click on OK. Now the model is imported from structure wizard software to StatPro software now. So after that, click on hide snap node grid. Keep your structure in 3D view. So for this respective base, initially we need to model the bracings for the corners of this respective tank. So for that, go to click on add beam command, select the first point, select the second point. So after that, again select the first point here, again select the second point, select the first point, select second point. In the same way, we need to give the bracings for the remaining section also. So after creating the ground story, we need to copy these respective bracings and beams and column sections to the remaining 3 stories. So for that, initially we need to select all by using Ctrl A button. Go to transitional repeat option in Y direction. So here we need to assume the number of steps. Just I am assuming the number of steps will be equal to 3 and each step will be consisting of 3 meter. Click on OK. So after that, it will create the beams, columns and bracings like this. So after this, we need to model the remaining tank. So for that, initially we need to keep the structure in front of you. So we need to create the cantilever beam sections for this respective tank at the top. So for that, click on cut section command, select two view option, click on OK. So here we need to cut this respective top portion initially. So after that, keep your structure in 3D view. So here we need to select the node sections. Just I am selecting this 3 node points, click on copy option, click on paste nodes. In x direction distance, which is consisting of 1 meter, click on OK. So after that, again we need to select the left hand section 3 node points, click on copy option, again click on paste nodes. In x direction with value of -1, click on OK. So after that, we need to select this respective 3 node points in the similar way, click on copy again. So click on paste nodes again. In z direction distance, which is consisting of 1 meter, click on OK. So after that, we need to select the remaining 3 node points, click on copy option again, click on paste nodes again in z direction, which is consisting of -1 distance, click on OK. So after that, we need to click on 3D command, So here we need to join these respective node points with the help of the beams. So for that, select add beam command, select the first beam, select the second beam. So in the same way, we need to add the cantilever beam sections for this respective tank. So after that, we need to copy these respective node points also in 1 meter distance in order to create the cantilever slab. So for that, select node cursor. So here we need to select these two node points, click on copy option, click on paste nodes in x direction distance which is consisting of 1 meter, click on OK. So after that, again we need to select these respective node points in the same way, click on copy option. So again click on paste nodes which is at a distance of -1 meter, click on OK. So it will create the node points like this. So after that, we need to connect these respective node points with the help of the slab section. So for that, go to click on generate surface meshing option. So initially we need to select the first point here, again we need to select the second point here, again we need to select the third point, again we need to select the fourth point, again we need to come to the first point. So after that, we need to select the type of mesh generation. So here I am assuming type of mesh generation is quadrilateral meshing, click on OK. So here we need to assume the divisions for the respective length of 8 meter. This time taking the divisions will be consisting of 8 divisions for each and every meter. This time taking it as 8 for all sections. Click on apply button. So it will generate the meshing for this respective slab like this. So after that, we need to create the column sections for the remaining tank. So for that, select node point cursor, select your first node point, select second node point, again we need to select third node point. In the same way, we need to select the node points here. So just I am selecting the node points, click on rotate option. So here we need to select the corner node points. So here we need to select one more node point. So here I am selecting one more node point. So after that, click on copy option, again click on paste nodes option. So here we need to give the y direction distance. Just I am taking height of the tank is 5 meter. So here we need to give the value of 5 in y direction, click on OK. So after that, click on front view option. Again by using control option, we need to select the node points at the top. So we need to connect these respective node points with the help of the column section. For that, go to geometry option, click on connect beams along y axis. So it will create the 8 number of columns here. So after that, we need to create the walls for this respective tank. So for that, initially click on top view, go to cut section command. So here we need to select the selective view option, click on OK. So here I am selecting this respective portion for this tank. So again we need to click on 3D view. So after that, again we need to click on front view option. So again in the same way, we need to select cut section command, selective view option, click on OK. So here we need to cut the top portion for this respective tank. So after that, click on 3D view. So here we need to add the walls for this respective section. So for that, again we need to select the generate surface meshing option, select the first point, select the second point, select the third point, again select your fourth point, again come to first point. So here we need to select the quadrilateral again, click on OK again. So here I am assuming divisions along one direction, two direction, three direction, four direction will be 666. Click on apply. So after that, again click on generate surface meshing option for the second section also. Select the first point here, select the second point, select the third point, select the fourth point, again come to your first point. Again quadrilateral meshing, click on OK. So here we need to assume the dimensions as 666, click on apply. So after that, again we need to add one more section. This time selecting second point, third point, again fourth point, again come to first point, again quadrilateral, click on OK. Divisions will be 666 here, click on OK. So after that, we need to rotate this respective model. Again we need to add the slab section for the remaining model. Select the first point here, again I am selecting second point here, again I am selecting third point here, again I am selecting fourth point here, again come to the first point. Quadrilateral meshing, click on OK. So here I am selecting divisions are 6, again click on apply button. So it will apply the respective tank like this. So after that, we need to save this respective model. So click on whole structure command. So this is my model for this respective elevated rectangular tank. So I will show you this respective model in 3D rendering view. So for that, click on rendering view option. So this is my rendering view for this respective tank. So it will be consisting of 6 meter length and 6 meter width, and tank dimensions will be consisting of 6 meter in length direction and 6 meter in width direction, and height of the tank is 5 meter. So for this respective tank, we need to apply the properties. Nothing but your beam size, column size, and bracing thickness and slab thickness. So for that, initially go to general option here. Click on properties here. So here we need to add the steel sections for these respective beams, columns, and the remaining section. So for that, initially we need to select the section database option here. So it will load the respective section database profile table like this. So here we need to select the Indian code. So here I am selecting W section here. Next, I am selecting W 450 by 350 by 16 for the column section. So again I am selecting one more section for the beam section, which is consisting of 400 by 300 by 16 section. Click on add button again. Click on close option. So here we need to select the 400 by 300 by 16 section. We need to apply these respective sections for the beam. So for that, go to select option, beams parallel to X direction. Again I am selecting beams parallel to Z direction. Click on assign to selected beams. Assign, yes. So after that, we need to select the 450 by 350 by 16 section. So we need to apply these respective sections for the column. Go to select beams parallel to Y direction. Click on assign to selected beams. Assign, yes. So after that, go to select the thickness option. So here I am selecting the plate thickness for the material of steel section. Next, I am taking it as 120 mm. So click on add button, close option. So we need to assign this respective plate thickness for the respective section. So click on assign to view option. Assign, yes. So after that, we need to give the dimensions for the respective bracings. So for that, go to click on section database again. So here we need to select the Indian code again. Again I am selecting the angle section here. So here I am taking angle section will be consisting of ISA 150 by 150 by 20 for the bracing section. Click on add option, close option. So here we need to select ISA 150 by 150 by 20. We need to apply this respective section for the bracings. So for that, go to select option, select by missing attribute. So here we need to select by missing property. So it will select all the bracing section for this respective tank. Click on assign to selected beams. Assign, yes. So after that, we need to see this respective whole model in 3D rendering view. For that, click on 3D rendering view option here. So this is my 3D rendering view for this respective tank, which is consisting of steel sections for the beam, column, as well as bracing sections. So after modeling this respective tank, we need to give the supports and load cases for this respective tank. So for that, initially go to general option again. Again, we need to create the fixed supports by using supports options here. Click on create option here. Add your fixed supports. Select your support 2 by using front view option. We need to select all the node points at the base. Again, we need to select assign to selected nodes. Assign, yes. So after that, click on 3D view. So after that, we need to apply the load cases for this respective tank. So for this tank, just I am assuming load cases will be consisting of dead load and water pressure. So for that, initially go to select loads and definitions option here. Click on load case details option here. Click on add button here. So initially we need to define the dead load as well as water pressure values. So select your dead load option. Just I am giving the title as DL here. Click on add button. Again I am selecting the fluid load here, which is consisting of title of WP. Click on add button. So close option. Select your dead load option. So click on add button. So here we need to add a self-weight factor, which is consisting of -1 factor in Y direction. Click on add button, close option. Select the self-weight factor by using assign to view option. Assign, yes. So after that, select the water pressure option. So we need to apply the water pressure for this respective tank for the plate sections only. So for that, initially we need to click on add button here. Select the plate pressure, nothing but plate loads. So here we need to select the hydrostatic pressure, nothing but your water pressure. So it will ask you to select the plates here. Click on select to plates option here. So here we need to select these respective plates by using plate command. So just we need to select all the plates here. Click on done option. So it will open the respective value of force W1 as well as W2 here.
W1 is nothing but your minimum pressure for the water, and W2 is nothing but maximum global axis pressure for the water. Just I am assuming minimum pressure will be -5 kN/m², and maximum pressure, just I am taking it as -25, which is acting in y direction as well as gy direction. Click on add button, so it will load the respective values for this tank like this. So click on close option. So after that, select the materials option here, select the material as steel here, click on assign to view option, assign, yes. So after that, go to analysis and print, add your no print option here, click on close option here, go to analyze option, run analysis, save it. So here we need to check for the zero errors for this respective elevated steel tank. If you observe with zero errors, then our model is correct. So here my model is observed with zero errors here. Go to post processing mode, click on done option. So here we need to apply these two load cases. Click on apply, click on OK. So it will load this respective deflection diagram like this. So this is the deflection diagram for this respective tank due to presence of water pressure. So just I am selecting the load case to dead load case. So after that, select the beam here, deselect the MZ value, select FY. So this is the shear force diagram for this respective tank. So after that, we need to select the load case to water pressure. So select MZ value, deselect FY value, select the load case as dead load here. So this is the bending moment diagram for this respective tank due to presence of dead load case. Again, we need to select the water pressure case. So after that, select the plate pressure. So here I am applying stress type as maximum absolute pressure. Apply, OK. So this is the maximum absolute pressure for this respective tank due to presence of water pressure. Select the load case to dead load case. So this is the dead load case water pressure diagram. So this is the water pressure diagram for this respective tank due to presence of hydrostatic pressure. Select the animation here, click on deflection option. So here I am selecting deflection, apply, OK. So this is the deflection due to presence of water pressure, and this is the deflection of the tank due to presence of the dead load case. For checking the values of the deflection, shear as well as bending moment, we need to design this respective tank by using IS 800 steel code. So for that, go to modeling option here, click on design option here. So here you need to select the steel code. Just I am selecting the current code as IS 800 2007 LSD section here. Click on select to parameters here. So initially we need to deselect all parameters. So from these parameters, we need to pick track parameter initially. So after that, we need to select the yield strength of the steel. Just I am selecting yield strength of the steel. Click on OK. Again, click on define parameters. So here I am assuming yield strength of the steel will be consisting of 600,000. Click on add button. Again, I am selecting track values. So this is the track parameters, which is consisting of three values here, 0, 1, 2. So 0 is nothing but print design output at a minimum detail level, and 1 is nothing but print output at intermediate detail level. So 2 is nothing but print the design details at maximum design level. So here I am selecting as maximum details level. Click on add button, close option. So after that, select the comments option. So here we need to select the check code option, click on add button. So after that, we need to select the member takeoff here, click on add button. Again, we need to select the select option, click on add button. Again, I am selecting takeoff command, click on add button, close option. So after that, we need to assign this respective question mark for this respective section. So just I am selecting yield strength by using assign to view option, assign to the whole tank, click on S button. Select the track also by using assign to view option, assign, yes. Again, select the check code option by using assign to view, assign, yes. Again, I am selecting steel member takeoff, assign to view, assign, yes. So after that, we need to assign this respective question marks also. Just I am selecting select option here, click on assign to view, assign, yes. Again, select steel takeoff by using assign to view option, assign, yes. So after that, go to analysis and print option again. Again, click on add button, close option here. So after that, again go to analyze option, click on run analysis, save it. So here we need to check for the zero errors for this respective design also. So here my model is checking for the zero errors. So here my model is observed with zero errors. Go to post processing mode again, click on done option again. Again we need to select the beam, again deselect the bending moment diagram. So here we need to select any one of the beam section. Just I am selecting this respective beam member 11, just double click on it, click on steel design. So this is the steel design for this respective section. It will be consisting of 350 by 300 by 10. But as per our assumption, just we are assumed 400 by 300 by 16 section. But as per the design, as per the load calculations, it will give the value of 350 by 300 by 10 is sufficient for designing of this respective tank. So after that, select this design property. So this is the design property data, deflection value, shear bending values. So after that, select any one of the column. Just I'm selecting this respective column. Just double click on it. Click on steel design. So this is the steel design. So this steel design also consisting of 350 by 300 by 10 section. As per my assumption, just I was assumed 450 by 300 by 16 section for the respected column section. While designing this respective section, as per the load calculation, just it is showing 300 by 300 by 10 is sufficient to design this respective elevated tank. So this is the design property data and deflection value, shear bending, loading option. So after that, select the respective plate. So here I am selecting this respective plate, just double click on it. So it will show the value of central stresses, property constraints, corner stresses and geometry values for this respective section. So after designing this respective elevated tank, we need to see the STAD output file. So for that, click on STAD output file option here. So it will load the respective STAD output file like this. So here we need to select the steel design results. So this is the steel design results for these respective members as per IS 800-2007 LSD section. So this is the each and individual calculations for this respective tank as per IS 800 code. So we need to check the value of reinforcement for this respective section from this output. Now we have to design the foundation for this respective tank. So for that, initially click on foundation design here. So include your all load cases, click on run STAD foundation. The fixed supports of this respective steel tank will be directly imported to STAD foundation software. So these are the fixed supports. We need to design the foundation for these respective fixed supports. So for that, initially we need to generate the load combinations. So for that, go to click on loads and factors here. Click on generate load combinations here. So here we need to select the code as Indian code. Click on generate load combinations for the service load combination initially. So after that, click on generate load combinations for the ultimate load combination. Click on OK. So after that, we need to define the job setup. Click on place mark here. Click on create job. So here we need to give the job name. Just I am assuming the job name is A. Select the isolated footing job information. Just I am selecting a units as Indian system and SI system units assigned to all supports. So here we need to include the load cases. Just I am including all load cases for this design case. Click on create job. So it will design this respective job output. So click on isolated footing job. So click on design parameters. So concrete and rebar values, this is cover and soil type values, this footing geometry values, this sliding and overturning moment. Click on design option, click on S button. So it will design the isolated footing as per IS 456-2000 code. This is the as per IS 456-2000 code isolated footing job. Select any one of the footing. Just I'm selecting isolated footing 3. So this is the isolated footing 3 design results and each and individual calculations for this respective foundation. So click on starting page. So this is our starting page. So this is the geometry. This is the details of our drawing. So click on GA drawing. So this is a GA drawing for this foundation. Click on calculation sheet. So this is the process analysis and designing of elevated steel tank by using StatPro V8i software. Thank you.